Hi everybody. Good morning. Myself Dr. P. Sivashankari, Associate Professor, PC Department, SNS College of Technology. Today I'm going to discuss a case study on how to choose a right operational amplifier for filtering circuits. Analog filter can be found in almost every electronic circuits. Audio systems use them for pre-amplification and equalization. In communication systems, analog filters can be used for tuning specified frequency and filtering the others. If an analog signal is digitized, low-pass filters are always used to prevent aliasing errors from out-of-band noise and interference.
Yes. So coming to the circuit, here we can classify this analog filters into two types. That is, one can be configured as a second order low pass filter. At DC the gain is positive, and the same another the gain as negative. So analog filtering can remove higher frequency noise superimposed on the analog signal before it reaches the analog to digital converter. In particular, this includes low level noise as well as extraneous noise peaks. Any signal that enters the analog to digital converter is digitized. If the signal is beyond half of the sampling frequency of the converter, the magnitude of such signal is converted reliably, but the frequency is modified as it aliases back into the digital output. Now we can see a digital filter to reduce the noise after digitizing the signal. But keep in mind the rule of the thumb. Okay, so the task of selecting the correct single supply operational amplifier for an active low pass filter circuit can appear overwhelming. As you read any op-amp datasheet and view all of the specifications. For instance, the number of DC and AC electrical specifications in microchips, 5 MHz single supply. When selecting an op-amp for your active low-pass filter, you can choose your amplifier based on these two specifications. There are two additional specifications that can be considered before reaching the final decision. The most common topologies for second-order active low-pass filters are, as the circuit shown here, AC the gain is negative, at DC the gain is negative, and the same at the DC the gain is positive. In this figure, in this circuit, you can see the non-inverting silent key is designed so that the input signal is not inverted. A gain option is implemented with R3 and R4. You can see the resistances R1, R2, R3, R4 and capacitances C1, C2 and input voltage, output voltage as Vin, Vout, and also we have a reference voltage. The two key specifications that you should initially consider when designing with either of these topologies is gain bandwidth product and slew rate. Prior to the selection of the op-amp, you need to determine the filter cutoff frequency that can be mentioned as FC. This is also known as the frequency where your filter starts to attenuate the signal. Sometimes in literature, you will find that this is called the passband frequency. Once this is done, the filter design software program can be used to determine the capacitor and resistor values also. Since we have already defined about cutoff frequency, selecting an amplifier with the right bandwidth is very, very easy. The closed loop bandwidth of the amplifier must be at least 100 times higher than the cutoff frequency of the filter. If you are using the silent key configuration, our filter gain is plus 1 volt. The gain bandwidth product GBWP of our amplifier should be equal to greater than 100 frequency. If the closed loop gain is larger than plus 1 volt, then it should be equal to greater than 100 GB. So, as coming to the multiple feedback configuration, this is equal to the inverting gain of closed loop system. So since we have already seen the bandwidth product, the bandwidth about the details of bandwidth, here the gain bandwidth product of microchip op-amps can be segregated with certain tables, So how each bandwidth differs? So we can see in a set of tables that can be explained. Before that, in addition to paying attention, with this table, we can see the product GBWP slew rate, input common mode, input bias current at room temperature. Everything is classified. So in this, in addition to paying attention to the bandwidth of your amplifier, the slew rate should be evaluated in order to ensure that the filter does not create signal distortions. The slew rate of an amplifier is determined by internal currents and capacitance. When large signals are sent through the amplifier, the appropriate current charges these in.
So students, I hope you understood. Finally, I would like to conclude that choosing a right operational amplifier plays a vital role in determining the quality of the filtering circuits. Thank you.